be talking about amino acids.
Protein? Looks like a fibroin protein. Carbohydrate. Well, we find him in the Reaper's tent like this here. Oh no! What's me here? Fiber one more minute. Now remember, you happen to love our place, a room like this, and the scientists. The lioness, the coyote, the lions. I'm relying here. Stay tuned for everyone.
Hydrolysis. Okay, now
you
don't have proteins.
Okay, you know what?
I just want you to know that the ionization states of those functional groups, that's what that's called, right? Whether or not they're behaving as proton donors or acceptors, it just depends on the pH of the solution. Okay, so it really doesn't matter how you draw them.
We're going to take two amino acids, two monomers, and we're going to join them together in that reaction, dehydration synthesis.
And the bond we make is an alphabetized table of amino acids. Here's a mnemonic for those. But ladies and gentlemen, this is not the way to do it. Right? It's all about chemical properties.
Amino acids. We're a protocol here.
Subdivided based on whether they have an aromatic ring.
Then we've got the polar. Fiona has me here. Those are the categories. This is what's going to dictate how amino acids behave in a protein.
So the function and the structure of the protein is dictated by the amino acids in the chain.
Primary is the order of amino acids in the chain.
What determines that is the DNA sequence, right? So DNA to messenger RNA, we've got transcription, and then on the ribosomes, we've got translation, the messenger RNA into the final protein. So if you haven't learned this yet, you will. The dictionary of life, right? This is how messenger RNA encodes all 20 amino acids.
There's a heaven so
well. How about a quick example? Let's look at glucagon. This is the primary structure of glucagon. It is just the order of amino acids in the chain.
Please don't.
By the way, glucagon is a peptide hormone made by alpha cells of the pancreas.
Okay, everybody. And the individual amino acids makes a big difference.
These are diseases which are caused by a single
amino acid chain. Stop it right there. I don't care
what mutation. Let's look at sickle cell anemia as an example, where the red blood cells take on a sickle shape. This happens because of one amino acid switch from glutamic acid to valine. So yeah, the order makes a big difference. Next level of protein structure we call secondary. These are regions of regular folding due to hydrogen bonds between amino acids that are close to each other. And specifically, we're talking about bonds between atoms in the backbone. So we are not talking about the side chain. We're talking about the
Two
different types of secondary structures. We call them alpha helices and beta sheets. Both of these structures.
I don't know, Ray. You feel bad? Oh no! I got it all right then.
So we're going to look at
alpha
helix.
You don't ask me.
So if this represents the primary structure of amino acids, it's kind of like a wet noodle, right? It's just a chain of amino acids, no shape. Look what happens when you roll it up into an alpha helix. Now I've got something that's really rigid and strong. Alpha helices provide seven places where this protein crosses the membrane. How does it stay there?
You get it.
How does this protein stay in the lipid bilayer?
Well, isn't it great?
It's chemistry. The non-polar amino acids are inside the lipid bilayer.
Yeah.
The polar amino acids are in the extracellular and intracellular fluids. So the properties and sequence of the amino acids are what keep the receptor anchored in a fluid lipid bilayer.
I don't care what
our sequence.
It is all
about structure. As an example, in another way, we're going to look at hemoglobin. The alpha helices here actually keep the shape of this protein. Hemoglobin binds up to four molecules of oxygen gas. And it is mainly alpha helices that hold the thing together. All right, let's look at beta sheets.
Let's go on.
Again, just the primary structure. I try and use it to hold up another penguin. But if I fold the paper into a beta sheet, same size paper, a lot more structure.
Let's get out of there.
Beta sheets are what accounts for the strength of that fibroin protein I showed you in the beginning.
No, not yet. Today,
you're
a lesson.
Not only do all
you're beautiful.
It's because of the shape of the beta sheets.
You kidding me?
All right, we're up to the third level of protein structure. The third level is either close by or across distances in four different types of interactions. And the primary structure is a three-dimensional.
Sorry for that. I can't hear. No one. The answer is no. I think actually here
between
lower
side groups.
Oh shit!
This is also where we get into denaturing
what
agents,
is this
right?
Place?
So these denaturing agents can cause those tertiary structures
I
to
think
break
actually,
down.
Well,
sometimes
here,
they're reversible.
Here is a
sometimes they're not. You've probably fried an egg. That
whatever,
is the denaturing of the egg white protein. Albumin.
Sorry,
finally, quaternary structure. This happens when you have two or more polypeptide units. So, di meaning two, tri, tetramer, which just refers to the number of units that have to be assembled for the final protein to work. We generally categorize them as fibrous or globular. Let's look at hemoglobin, but it's colored in a different way. So now each of the four subunits shine in a different color, and you see how all four are assembled to make the final what? Functional.
Oh no, what a mirror, Jean. All right. Oh man, so what's she going? What seen oh man, what's she going now?
Amino acids are the key. Primary level of structure
what?
Is the sequence what dictated by the DNA.
Play?
Secondary
what
regions of regular folding.
Maybe
these
right?
Are between
yeah,
atoms
so.
In the backbone itself, no, not the side
no.
chains.
No,
and we form
I'm
alpha
what?
Helices and beta
what?
Sheets. Really, the structural
oh, no.
sort of framework of all proteins.
Not quite good.
Tertiary
that's
divided
enough.
Into
no.
four different
that's
types
time
of bonds.
One
and those
here.
Are between side groups.
No, me.
Right, those side what? Chains are interacting
stop.
And forming
that's
a complex
no
three-dimensional
thanks.
Shape.
Quaternary,
you've got two or more polypeptide chains that are assembled into a single function.